Yes, this really works.
No, it doesn't, because this project is fake, and it is also not mine. It is a project by the YouTube channel Robotics Kanti, and a viewer of mine actually sent me the link to check it out. And I recommend you to watch it as well, because what I saw and what I found out about it is just crazy. Now first off, the main idea of the project sounds plausible. You got a laser diode that shoots out a red beam, and then you got four coils around it that alternately get powered to act as electromagnets, in order to attract the laser diode and thus let it move in a specific way to create an image with the beam. Like I said, sounds plausible, but after building the project myself and having a look at all the information the creator provided, I have to say that there are so many mistakes and things that just don't make any sense, it is kind of embarrassing. And worst of all, he makes extra money through wrong component affiliate links, in case someone wants to recreate this thing. So to stop the spread of misinformation, I will prove why this thing will never work, show you what huge mistakes were included, and at the end try to create my own real laser diode display to show you what is actually possible. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, who now offer flexible PCBs. And of course, that comes with a super special offer, meaning prices start at only $25. Their flexible PCBs are made with excellent quality raw materials, allow for great flexibility, and are ultra lightweight. And best of all, of course, they easily bend for your unique design. Check them out today, and while you're at it, maybe visit their new 3D model sharing platform and get yourself a $7 coupon for their 3D model service. Let's start off creating the original project by grabbing ourselves one of those 5-volt laser diodes, of which there's really only one kind popular on the internet. And the first good news is that its enclosure truly gets a bit attracted by magnets, so dragging it around with magnetic forces is possible. And that brings us to the project's main structure, onto which the diode gets secured in the middle and the coils all around it. Now my final version of this required object looked like this, but it was not my first version of it, and I actually had to try out a few different sizes and whatnot. All because the original creator didn't provide any information about the dimensions of this thing. So what I did was figuring out how big the diode was, and then estimating how big the rest has to be so that it fits in comparison. Another helpful clue I got though was the wire size used, which is linked in the video description through an affiliate link. It is apparently a 0.1mm enamel copper wire, and luckily for me, I got that laying around. But I immediately noticed that the 0.1mm wire is super thin in comparison to the wire shown in the video, meaning this is not 0.1mm wire, and the creator basically leads interested makers to the wrong product while making a profit. Lovely. So after doing my own research, it seems like he was using something like 0.45mm wire, which I of course also had plenty of laying around. And according to the wire size and laser diode size, I finally came up with my own fitting model for this project, which I then 3D printed. Next I of course had to wind the first electromagnet coil, and let's just say that according to the given information, I had no idea how many windings were used. But I made sure that my coil was thicker in the end, because that means I could make it more powerful, and thus be on the safe side. So with the first coil complete, I removed the varnish from its ends and measured its resistance, which seems to be around 3 ohm. And that actually fits great, because according to the schematic given by the original creator, we should use 9 to 12 volts for the coils. And with a 3 ohm resistance, that would equal a current flow of 3 to 4 amps, which my power supply should be able to handle. But before hooking up the coil, let's create the back piece for the laser diode, attach two longer wires to it, as well as a piece of silvered copper wire to later give it some stability in the middle, and push that all through the back piece and glue it all in place. And with the diode being in position, it was finally time to power the electromagnets, which, as you can see, the laser diode does not care too much about. Because yes, the created electromagnetic field of this coil construction is way too small to attract the diode in any way significantly. I mean, even normal magnets are not very attracted to this magnetic field, even though we are definitely at the power limit of this electromagnet, because it was heating up very quickly. Okay, at this point I think it is pretty clear that this diode electromagnet construction does not work the way it got advertised by the creator. But worst of all, this is just one big mistake of many in this project. For example, let's have a closer look at the schematic, where you can easily find three other big mistakes. First off, the laser diode gets directly powered by a digital pin of the Arduino, which sounds plausible. But once you realize that the diode draws around 70 milliamps at 5 volts, and an Arduino pin cannot provide that amount of current continuously, you know that this will not work. Next, you see such n-channel MOSFETs that get used to control the current and thus power going to the coils, which once again sounds plausible, because as you can see, MOSFETs can do such a thing. But in this case, the MOSFETs are simply wired up incorrectly, meaning the supply voltage connects to source and the coil goes to drain. If we look at the datasheet of the MOSFETs, we can easily figure out that if we would do such a thing, current would flow continuously through the body diodes, and thus we would permanently power the coil no matter what control voltage we apply to the gates. And even if we would wire up the MOSFETs correctly and control them, there would still be the problem of huge voltage spikes appearing across them, which eventually would also destroy them. The reason for those voltage spikes is the collapsing electromagnetic field of the coils, which we can easily decrease significantly by adding flyback diodes across them, which are of course missing in the schematic though. And these were only three problems I found immediately. I bet there are tons more when you take some time to think about this project. And as a final nail in this coffin, let me say that the Arduino code the creator provided for this project does not even compile. So all in all, the presented project never worked and will never work. But honestly speaking, I thought that the initial idea for this was rather intriguing, and thus I wondered whether I could create something functional along those lines. To do that, I of course firstly had to cut a piece of iron rod to size, because every good electromagnet needs a ferromagnetic core. And after winding tons of wire around it, I actually ended up with a resistance very close to the electromagnet from before. Thus it also drew around the same power as before, but this time our laser diode did get attracted to it, and other magnets, of course, noticed it way faster. So this kind of electromagnet could be the solution to creating a functional laser display, which meant I made one more of it for testing, designed a custom structure to place it all in, 3D printed that, mounted the diode and two magnets onto it, built a custom control PCB with Arduino and MOSFETs, connected everything, and ultimately wrote a bit of code that turns on the two electromagnets alternately. And after then powering everything, it was clear to me that this idea does hold some potential. Meaning next, I created two more magnets, secured them close to the diode, and adjusted the Arduino code a bit so that it powers all four coils one after the other, meaning our resulting image should look something like a square or circle, right? Well, first off, the diode did move, but the resulting image was not really what I was hoping for. But that is okay, because for a reliable laser display system like these, we would need perfectly adjusted magnets and maybe even a feedback system to draw proper images. And that is something I'm not interested in making, because that would be way too much effort for something that is not really useful. So all in all, such a laser display is possible to make, but certainly not as simple to do as shown by other creators on the internet. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video and maybe learned something new along the way. If so, consider supporting me through Patreon so that I can keep the show going. As always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!